Hello everyone. Today I will be delivering the lecture on ecosystem. The term ecosystem was derived by A.G. Tansley in 1935. The various scientists defined ecosystem in a different ways, but Sir A.G. Tansley defined ecosystem as interaction between a living and a non-living components. He says the ecosystem can be a small or ecosystem can be a large. Ecosystem can be natural or ecosystem can be a artificial. Ecosystem can be a small or ecosystem can be a large. So on this basis, he classified ecosystem into majorly two types. One is called as natural ecosystem, another one is called as artificial ecosystem. Artificial ecosystem. Natural ecosystem means without the interference of the man, this ecosystem have been produced. This is called as natural ecosystem. With the interference of the man, some of the ecosystem have been produced. That is called as an artificial ecosystem. Coming towards the natural ecosystem, the concept, the natural ecosystem, again it has been classified majorly into two types. One is called as aquatic ecosystem, another one is called as terrestrial ecosystem. Terrestrial ecosystem. The terrestrial ecosystem, in other words, is called as land ecosystem. Majorly, A.G. Tansley, based on his existence, he classified into majorly three types. One is called as forest ecosystem, second one is called as grassland ecosystem, third one is called as desert ecosystem. And he continues the prologue. These are the major three types: forest, desert, and the grassland ecosystem will be coming towards the terrestrial ecosystem. These are the major important for the land ecosystem. Coming towards the aquatic ecosystem, this is being classified into majorly two types. One is called as freshwater ecosystem, another one is called as marine water ecosystem. The freshwater includes the below 3% of the salt water bodies which is being present in the globe. Those ecosystems are all coming towards the freshwater ecosystem. These are the few examples. We can give the lakes, the streets, etc., etc. The freshwater ecosystem again has been classified into majorly two types. One is called as lotic ecosystem, another one is called as lentic ecosystem. The lotic ecosystem can be defined as the flowing aquatic water bodies is called as lotic ecosystem. The stagnant water bodies is called as lentic ecosystem. The flowing water bodies, we can give the example like the rivers, streams, etc. The lentic means the stagnant or standing water bodies. We can give the example like the pools, ponds, ditches, etc. Coming towards the marine water ecosystem, this means we can give the example like the seas, ocean, estuaries, because these three been increased in the salt content. That is, the 3% or above or in the water resources are called as marine water resources. Yeah, we say the sea, ocean, estuaries. Again, the word estuary means we can say the adjoining of the fresh water into it. The marine water is called as estuarine ecosystem. So this is the natural ecosystem classification. Coming towards the artificial ecosystem, this was the man-made ecosystem. Based on this artificial examples, we can give like our classroom ecosystem, college, garden ecosystem, cities, dams, etc., etc. These are the artificial ecosystem. Based on this, he classifies ecosystem majorly into three types. Kinds of ecosystem can be classified into three types. One is called as physical, ecosystem. Second one is called as organic. Third one, components, organic components. Third one is inorganic, inorganic components. This includes the physical conditions and the climatic factors which will be influencing the biotic factors. These are the major factors which influence the biotic components. Example like physical components, organic components and the inorganic components. The physical components, example, you can say a pH, the sunlight, the temperature, etc., etc. These are the major factors which influence for the biotic components. The pH can be defined as the negative logarithm of hydrogen ion concentration, the sunlight is freeze coming, the wind is freeze coming. Okay, these all components will be utilized by the certain biotic components for their living, for their the future process. Organic components includes like the what you call as protein, carbohydrates, pista, etc., etc. These are all called as organic components. Inorganic components includes like carbon, nitrogen, etc. This all includes the inorganic components. This is all components which is occurring freely in the nature. If using the nature, these biotic components, based on the nourishment, the biotic components can be classified. This is all coming towards the abiotic components. The major components in the ecosystem are two types. One is called as abiotic components, another one is called as biotic components. Now, in a few minutes before, I informed regarding the abiotic components. Now, we shall discuss regarding the dibiotic components. The biotic components can be classified into two types. One is called as autotrophs, another is called as heterotrophs. Mainly this classification is being done by the nourishment of a food. The food nourishment, these two types. This is derived from the Latin word auto means self, troph means nourishment. The self-nourishing organisms are called as autotrophs. And heterotrophs means, hetero means other, troph means nourishment. The organism which depend on other, those organisms are called as heterotrophs. Autotrophs or other word we can call it as producers, or we can call it as producers. Producers means using the abiotic components, certain living organisms will prepare its own food. Okay, example, we can say the carbon dioxide which is freely existing in nature is an inorganic component. The water which is existing freely is an inorganic component. The sun, using the sunlight, the chlorophyll pigment will be there in the green plants. It will produce some energy. It acts like the food that is called as a glucose. This is called as a photosynthesis. The producers itself, using the sunlight, using the chlorophyll pigment in the green leaf, will prepare its own food. We can give an example for the producers like green algae, blue green algae. My certain microorganisms also is there, and like what we call is the phytoplanktons, like what you call as spirulina or blue green algae, etc., etc. These are the few examples for the producers. You, based on this producer, again, these autotrophs can be classified into majorly three types. One is called as producers, another one is called as consumers. Consumers can be classified into three types. One is called as primary consumers, second one is called as secondary consumers, third one is called as tertiary consumers. Primary consumers mainly depend on the producers for their food. Examples in a forest ecosystem, we can say a green leaf will be consumed by the deer. Deer is acting like the primary consumers in the forest ecosystem. This deer will be consumed by the fox, which acts at the secondary secondary consumers level. The secondary consumers level mainly depend on the primary consumers level for its food. Lastly, the tertiary consumers level, the fox will be consumed by the lion. The lion is the top consumers level, which is the, in any ecosystem, the tertiary consumers will be the last ecosystem, last consumers level. Examples in the forest ecosystem, we can say the tiger or lion is a top consumers level. In aquatic ecosystem, we can say the large fish will be a last top consumers level. This is the different biotic components. This is the what we call as the biotic components. Next, when we come towards the functions of an ecosystem, we classify the functions of an ecosystem into a productivity, a food chain, a food web, ecological pyramids, and ecological succession. These are the major important the functions of an ecosystem. There are the two significance in the ecological system. One is called as bioaccumulation, another one is called as a biomagnification. The flowing of a toxic material in any ecological system is called as bioaccumulation, or that toxic level which will be flowing in the food chain is called as a biomagnification process. Example, we can say a DDT or the pesticides or the insecticides which will be used in the agriculture field. The productivity means the amount of energy stored or accumulated in a certain unit of a time is called as a productivity. This productivity can be classified into two types. One is called as GPP, another one is called as NPP. GPP means the gross primary productivity, NPP means the net primary productivity. That means the gross means the total amount of energy stored. Net means the amount which will be lost to the yield. That is called as a net primary productivity. Based on this, the food chain can be classified into two types. One is called as the grazing feed chain, the other is called as a saprophytic food chain, or we can call as a detritus food chain. One more thing we can add, the parasitic food chain. The food chain is a process of flowing of energy from one trophic level to another trophic level, from producers to the top consumers level in a sequence chain manner, that is called as the food chain. Thus, coming towards the micro consumers level, that part I've left, the micro consumers level. The micro consumers means a large complex molecule will be breakdown into smaller micronutrients, that is called as a micro consumers. Examples we can call as a bacteria, fungus, etc. etc. We, the large complex molecule, after our death and decaying, it will be converted into complex nutrients in the soil. Those which will be converting, the large complex molecule will break down and will be converted into a fertile. After the decomposition, it will be done by the small minute organisms. These are the very, very important organisms, microorganisms in this globe. If we require the ecosystem balance, these micro consumers act a very, very important functions in the soil ecosystem. Coming towards the detritus food chain, as I said, the detritus means or saprophytes or to decompose those organisms which will be decomposed, the process of flowing the energy from a host to a microorganisms in a sequence chain manner is called as detritus food chain. The parasites means the organisms which depend on food and shelter within the same host, those organisms are called as parasites. The energy which will be transferred from the host to the parasites in the sequence chain manner is called as parasitic the food chain. There are various importance of the significance in the food chain process. In the next class, I will inform regarding this, the significance of food chain. Coming towards the foodware, the chain itself says the flow of energy from one ecosystem to another ecosystem, or from one tropic level to another tropic level in a sequence chain manner. Whereas in a web means it will be a various connectivity. The various connectivity are the various connection of the food chains to form the food web. Example, I will show you the grassland ecosystem. The grass will be consumed by a grasshopper. The grasshopper will be consumed by the lizard. This lizard will be consumed by the frog. This grass will be consumed by the rabbit. The rabbit will be consumed by the snake. This grasshopper, rabbit, lizard, snake, all will be consumed by the ant. See, the interaction is a web-like manner. This web-like manner is called as the food web process. These are the major important, I have said the two functions of an ecological system. Coming towards the ecological pyramids, Charles Elter, he classifies the pyramid in the ecological system. He plot the graphs in the triangle system. The broader part of the graph, the pyramid is called as a base. The smaller portion of the pyramid is called as an apex. He says the number, the biomass, the energy which will be much larger in their quantity in the globe, which will come and occupy the base of the pyramid. The small quantity which will be the least in number, that will come and occupy in the apex position of the pyramid. Based on this, he classifies into a majorly into three types. One is called as pyramid of number, pyramid of biomass, pyramid of energy.
the flow of energy from base to apex, it will go on reducing. This is called as a pyramid of number. The pyramid of energy from base to apex goes on reducing is called as a pyramid of energy. The base to the biomass will be goes on reducing from the base to apex is called as a pyramid of biomass. Next, very very important thing we should study on ecological succession. The basic, the definition I will say on the ecological succession, that is the process of changing an ecological